أهلا وسهلا بالجميع. في هذا الفيديو راح نكمل عن موضوع الـ channel capacity لـ discrete memoryless channel لـ Gaussian channels. فحتى نفهم موضوع الـ channel capacity أكثر بدنا نعرف موضوعين جداد، واحد فيهم اسمه الـ joint entropy والثاني اسمه الـ mutual information. We have this review from the previous video. Consider a source S with the following probability distribution. We have the symbol S1, S2 up to S sub m, and a probability distribution over the sample space P1, P2 up to P sub m. We defined entropy as summation minus pi log base 2 of pi and the units in bits per symbol. We have three different interpretations for the entropy. The entropy H is a measure of the amount of information in the source. It's a measure of the uncertainty in the source. It represents the minimum number of bits per symbol needed to represent the source. وهي اللي مرقت معنا على the source coding theorem. فهاي هي ال interpretations لل entropy. احنا راح نركز على ال definition الثاني وال definition الاول في هذا الفيديو حتى نوصل لمع ل ل ل لل concept of mutual information and channel capacity. The joint entropy. Let X be the input to a channel and let Y be the channel output. P of X and Y, the joint probability density function of X and Y. The joint occurrence of XJ and YK can be considered as a source in a two-dimensional space. So the joint entropy of X and Y represents the uncertainty in the joint event X and Y and is defined as H of X and Y in a similar way to the definition of the entropy, expected value of log 1 over P of X and Y. And since we are talking about a two-dimensional space, the expectation runs over all values of J and all values of K of this quantity, which is the joint density function of X and Y, log base 2 of the joint density function between X and Y. This is the two-dimensional extension of the first dimensional definition of the entropy. Entropy H represents, H of X represents the entropy in the source X. H of X and Y represents the amount of uncertainty in the joint event corresponding to the occurrence of the input X and output Y of a discrete memoryless channel. Now, we need to find an equivalent representation of the joint entropy. So the entropy H is the double summation over J and K of the joint density function between X and Y log base 2, the joint density function between X and Y. Okay, so we can use the well-known formula for the joint event of two random variables. That will be probability of xj times the probability of yk conditioned on xj log, again we write it in the same way, the probability p sub p of xj p of yk given xj. Then the log of the product of two quantities is the sum of the logs. So we expand this term log P of X, P of YK given XJ as log P of XJ plus log P of yk given xj and distribute the terms over the two summations. Having done that, we obtain this will be p of xj summation p of yk given xj log base 2 of xj minus p of xj and yk log base 2 of this quantity, which is yk given xj. So this is the representation. The summation over all values of y of this quantity equals 1, since this is the marginal density function of yk given xj. So this summation equals to 1, and we are left with probability of xj log base 2 of the probability of xj. This quantity is nothing but the entropy h of x. The second term, which is the joint density function p of xj yk log p of yk given xj, this quantity is called the conditional entropy. The conditional entropy of y given x. The entropy, the joint entropy of x and y equal the entropy in x plus the conditional entropy of y given x. What this statement means that the joint entropy of x and y is the uncertainty in x plus the remaining uncertainty in y after observing x, or equivalently, the joint entropy equal the uncertainty in y plus the remaining uncertainty in x after observing y. When x and y are independent, we can easily observe that the joint entropy equal the marginal entropies, h of x plus h of y. Or equivalently, the uncertainty in the joint event of x and y is just the uncertainty in y plus the uncertainty in x. The reason is that none of the if events x and y are independent, then none of these two events can convey information about the other event. So we have the uncertainty in the joint event is the sum of the uncertainty in x plus the remaining uncertainty in y after observing x, and similarly the uncertainty in the joint events is the sum of the uncertainties in x and y when they are independent. So the uncertainty is the sum of the uncertainties. Consider two random variables x and y with the joint PDF as shown in the table below. Find the joint entropy x of x and y, h of x, h of y given x, and h of x given y. In this example, we will learn how to compute these different quantities if we are given the joint density function between x and y. Let us understand the content in the table. X is a discrete random variable which assumes the values 0, 1, 2, 3. Y is another random variable assuming the values 0, 1, 2, and 3. 1/8 is the probability of the joint event that X assumes the value of 0 and at the same time Y assumes the value of 0. 1 over 16 represents the joint event of X having the value 2 and Y having the value 1. Similarly, this 1 over 16 is the probability that X assumes the value 2 and Y assumes the value 3. We can observe easily that the sum of all entries in the table is 1, which is the condition for any joint or marginal probability density function, that probability is always sum to one. فهي احنا عرفنا ال, these are the, this is the joint density function. ف we can employ the definition of the joint entropy h of x and y, which is the joint density log base 2 of the joint density, to calculate the joint entropy. فخلينا نشوف كيف بنحسب الجوينت انتروبي. H of X and Y, 1 over 8, we have one term and we have another term, so we have 2 times 1 over 8 log base 2 of 8, which is this quantity here, and plus 6, 1 over 16, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 6 times 1 over 16 log base 2 of 16 plus 1 fourth log base 2 of 4, because we have only one term with a probability of 1 4, plus 4 times 1 over 32 log base 2 of 32. 32, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So we have 4 terms. We do the calculation and we obtain that the joint entropy equals 3.375 bits. فهذا المطلوب الأول اللي هو الكالكوليشن للجوينت انتروبي H of X and Y. المسألة الثانية, the more difficult problem, is how to evaluate H of X and H of Y. H of X and H of Y, they depend on the marginal density functions of X and Y. In order to calculate H of X and H of Y, we need to find the marginal density functions for X and Y. And this is what is done here. Here, in this column, we calculate the marginal density function of X. So, we ask the question, what is the probability that X assumes the value 0? X assumes the value 0 if Y equal to 0, or Y equal to 1, or Y equal to 2, or Y equal to 3. So, we sum over all these probabilities horizontally. When we sum them, we obtain 1 fourth. Similarly, what is the probability that X takes on the value 1? Takes the value 1 when X, when Y is 0, or Y is 1, or Y is 2, or Y is 3. Again, we add all values and we get 1 fourth. Similarly, the probability that X equals to 2 and X equals to 3. So here we have these marginal density functions. So X takes on the value 0 with probability 1 fourth, it takes on the value 1 with probability 1 fourth, the value 2 with probability 1 fourth, and 3 with probability 1 fourth. Now, for the marginal density function of Y, Y takes on the value 0, and this happens when X is 0, or X is 1, or X is 2, or X is 3. So to get the probability that Y equal to 0, we sum over all these probabilities, we sum over all values of X, and when we do this summation, we obtain that the probability that X equal to 0 is 1 half. For the probability that Y equal to 1, Y equal to 1 is the probability that X is 0, or X is 1, or X is 2, or X is 3. Again, we sum these vertical probabilities and obtain 1 fourth. Here, the probability that Y equals to 2 is 1 eighth, which is the probability 1 over 32 plus 1 over 32 plus 1 over 16, and the probability that Y equals 1 eighth. The probability Y equals to 3 as 1 over 32 plus 1 over 32 plus 1 over 16. Here now we have these values correspond to the marginal density function of y. These values correspond to the marginal density function of x. Now we are in a position to calculate h of x and h of y. Now h of y equal 1/2, this 1/2, log base 2 of 2 plus 1/4 log base 2 of 4 plus 2 times 1/8, we have two terms, log base 2 of 8, and the result is 1.75 bits. Now for the entropy of x, we have four terms with equal probability. So we have 4 times 1/4 log base 2 of 4, and the result is 2 bits. So we have now calculated the joint entropy, the marginal entropy corresponding to the variable x, and the marginal entropy corresponding to the variable y and to the variable. حتى نحسب الـ conditional entropy of x given y, we recognize that h of x given y is h of the joint entropy, h of x and y minus h of y, which equals 3.375 minus 1.75, and that equals 1.625. Similarly, h of y given x is the joint entropy, h of x and y minus h of x, and again equals 3.375 minus 2 equal 1.375. A side note here, we observe that the entropy, the joint entropy x and y is larger than the entropy in x. The joint entropy in x and y is larger than the entropy in y, and the joint entropy is smaller than the sum in the two entropies. Okay, that's h of x and y equal to 3.375, while the joint h of x is 2, h of y is 1.75, so the sum is 3.75, while this quantity is 3.375, which is less than 3.75. زي ما شفنا في السلايد السابقة, الانتروبيز, الجوينت انتروبي والمارجنال انتروبيز بربطهم أكتر من علاقة. بشكل عام, we have this general result which says that the joint entropy is less than the marginal entropy of x plus the marginal entropy in y. At the end of this video, we will prove this result. However, for the purpose of continuity, we will skip the proof for the moment. So, if x and y are independent, random variables, then the joint density function is the product of the marginal density functions. In this case, we have that the joint entropy equal the marginal entropy in x plus the marginal entropy in y. Or we can state it that the joint uncertainty, or the uncertainty in the joint event of x and y, equal the uncertainty in x plus the uncertainty in y. The reason is that none of these two events convey information about the other event. So the uncertainty is the sum of the uncertainties. And as another consequence to the independence of x and y, we have that the conditional entropy of x given y is just h of x, in that y adds nothing to the knowledge about x because they are independent. And the same applies here, that the remaining uncertainty in y after observing x is just the uncertainty in y. So the uncertainty in y is the same whether we know x or we don't know x. So this is what we need about these different quantities. Graphically, if this is the joint event, then if this is the joint entropy, then the joint entropy equal the entropy in x plus the remaining entropy in y after observing x, and equals also the uncertainty in y plus the remaining uncertainty in x after observing y. So these two quantities, they add to the joint entropy, and these two quantities, h of x and h of y given x, they add also to the joint entropy. Next, we define the mutual. What do we mean by mutual information? Given two random variables, x and y, with marginal distributions p of x and p of y, the mutual information between x and y is the relative entropy between the joint distribution p of x and y and the product distribution p of x and y. It's a measure of the amount of information one random variable conveys about the other random variable. فناخد هذا الديفينيشن, that's the mutual information between x and y is p of x and y log base 2 of the joint density function divided by the marginal density function. شوية calculation, mathematical manipulation, we can observe that the mutual information is the uncertainty in x minus the remaining uncertainty about x after observing y, or equivalently, the uncertainty in y minus the remaining uncertainty in y after observing x. These two formulas can be obtained directly from the previous definition. H of x is the uncertainty about x. H of x and y is the remaining uncertainty about x after y is observed. So the difference is the amount of information conveyed by y, which means that there is a reduction in the uncertainty. So prior to observing y, we have a certain amount of uncertainty about x. Now, this uncertainty is resolved by observing y. So this is the remaining. Now, this quantity represents the remaining uncertainty in y after we in the remaining uncertainty in x after observing y. So the difference is the amount of information provided by our knowledge about the variable y. Similarly, we have h of y, the remaining the uncertainty in y, and if we know x, then there is a reduction in our uncertainty given by the quantity h of y given x, and the difference is the amount of information conveyed by through our knowledge about x. Graphically, we have the joint entropy h of x and y, which equals, as we said earlier, h of x plus h of y given x, and also equal h of x given y plus h of y. Now, the difference between h of x given y and h of x, this h of x minus h of x given y, this quantity here is the amount of information provided through our knowledge with y. Equivalently, h of y minus h of y given x, this difference is the amount of information given by these two formulas. So I of x and y is h of x this whole quantity minus h of x given y. That's the mutual information, or h of y minus h of y given x. This is the amount of information. We can calculate the mutual information من خلال معرفتنا بالإنتروبي h of x and h of x and y, أو h of y and h of y given x. Okay. مرة تانية بالنسبة للميوتشوال انفورميشن. So mutual information is the amount of uncertainty about the channel input x resolved by observing the channel output y. For a good channel, one would expect I of x and y to be as large as possible. On observing y, we are able to resolve x with a high degree of reliability. So in a communication system, we transmit x, okay? However, we receive x plus some noise. So we observe y, but still we don't know what the transmitter has sent. فإحنا مهتمين كتير كتير نعرف إيش اللي بعتنا إياه للترانسميتر. So the amount of information is our initial uncertainty about x. We have a certain uncertainty about x. However, after observing the actual output of the channel, we have a remaining uncertainty about x. We don't know for sure what x is. However, this amount of uncertainty has been reduced by observing y. The amount of reduction in the uncertainty, h of x minus h of x and y, is the mutual information between x and y. فهي هو التفسير المنطقي ليش تتسمى mutual information، لأنه إحنا هنا في mutual information عمال بناخد وبنحلل الانتروبي، بنعطيه المعنى تبع uncertainty. So we have a given uncertainty about x. We have a remaining uncertainty about x after observing y. The reduction in the uncertainty, the reduction in the uncertainty is the amount of information conveyed by observing y. على نفس المثال السابق, now we have this example about joint and conditional entropies. Consider two random variables x and y with the joint probability density function as shown in the table below. Find the mutual information between x and y. In the previous example, we were given this joint density function. We calculated the marginal density function of x and the marginal density of y. We performed the calculation that the joint entropy is 3.375 bits. Also, we calculated h of y to be 1.75 bits and h of x to be 2 bits. المطلوب نحسب the mutual information between x and y. We note that I of x and y, the mutual information between x and y is h of x minus h of x given y. But h of x given y is also given in terms of the joint entropy, h of x and y minus h of y. So in terms of calculation, we say that I of x and y is h of x plus h of y minus the joint entropy, h of x and y. Simply, h of x equal to h of y equal 1.75, h of x and y, the joint entropy 3.375, so the mutual information equal 0.375. So this is a simple way of calculating the mutual information when the joint density function between x and y is given. Finally, we need to prove that h of x is larger than h of x given y, or the remaining uncertainty about x after observing y is less than the initial uncertainty about x. So we resort to the definition of the entropy of X, H of X equal expected value of log 1 over P of X. And we can write it also in terms of the joint density function between X and Y, log base 2 of 1 over P of X. السبب إنه عملنا Y, it doesn't affect لأنه this summation over Y equals to 1. We have also the definition for H of X given Y. It's the expected value of log 1 over P of X and Y, which is again given in terms of the joint density function as the expected value. So when we perform the difference H of X minus H of X given Y, we obtain that this difference equal minus the joint density function P of X and Y log P of X over P of X given Y. So this is the logarithmic quantity P of X over P of X given Y. We know how the log function looks like. It's this curve, log of X, and this curve Y equal log X always lies below the curve Y equal X minus 1, except when X equal 1, the two curves they meet at this point. So at all other values of X, this curve is beneath this curve. فبنستفيد من هاي العلاقة وبنقول إنه the log of this quantity is less than or equal to the quantity minus 1. The quantity minus 1. فبنعوّد this probability of X given Y بناخذ الجوينت density function فبتصير عندنا P of X, P of Y over P of X and Y. بعدين نعمل المultiplication, we expand the summation فبصير عندي summation ل P of X, P of Y plus لأنه هنا في عندنا minus sign مع minus sign plus the joint density function P of X and Y. وطبعا بنعرف إنه summation over X and Y of a joint density function equal 1, this is plus 1, and again we sum over X and we sum over Y and the result is also 1. So we have minus 1 plus 1 equal to 0. This is the way we prove that the remaining uncertainty in X after observing Y is less than the initial uncertainty about X.